Hallie. I'm Sarah Nash. Today is Tuesday, October 17th, and on today's episode, Spirit Week information, senior reminders, and homecoming tickets. But first, today's daily pick was sent in by Ben Felter. He captioned the pick, "If pants were to wear a dog, how would they wear it?" Interesting question, Ben. You can go vote for your favorite option on our Twitter. Thanks for that once again. If you want your pick featured on the air, be sure to tweet it to us at Pally and Focus. Here is today's campus bulletin. Walter Hayes Elementary School is hosting its annual Fall Fest Carnival on Sunday, October 22nd. The event will take place at the school, and they are looking for high school students that would be interested in volunteering that day. Students can earn anywhere between 1 to 6 volunteer hours. They have many fun booths and games that need to be staffed. Shifts are from 1 to 2, 2 to 3, and 3 to 4. Students who are looking for community service hours or are Walter Hayes alumnus who want to participate, reach out to Zihan Selha at the first email on screen or Jeanette Reifenberg at the second email on screen. Today during Flex in room MAC 204, Noor Navaid will be mediating a discussion on whether or not football players should kneel during the national anthem. Students can sign up to participate or submit questions. Questions can be submitted to the first link on screen and are anonymous. Students who would like to participate can sign up at the second link on the screen. Homecoming tickets are being sold on the quad and outside the MAC for this whole week. Tickets are 5 with an ASB sticker and 10 without. Homecoming will be on Saturday, October 28th from 7 to 10. Thankfully, it will be in the big gym, so we won't have to break the floors at the computer museum. Speaking of homecoming, Noor Navaid is on the quad with more.
Homecoming tickets will be sold on the quad and outside of the MAC during lunch throughout the week. Also, the Capture the Flag tournament was postponed until further notice due to poor air quality. Additionally, Spirit Swap is happening throughout the whole week during lunch on the quad, so be sure to swap gear to prepare for next week.
The class of 2018 should sign up for their class Remind 101 for updates and reminder as Spirit Week approaches. They can do so by texting at PALLY2018 to 81010. Also, remember to get involved by participating in rally activities and come out to dance practices during lunch, flex, or after school. More information on Facebook and Schoology. Capture the Flag tournament is postponed due to the unhealthy air quality until further notice. Spirit Swap will be happening this whole week at lunch on the quad, so trade in your Spirit Week gear to prepare for next week. If anyone ordered Spirit Week clothes through the Ride Together Education Shop, the items have been packed up and are ready to pick up. Pickup will be available at a table on the quad during lunch today, Thursday, and Friday. Don't go anywhere, Pally. In Focus, we'll be right back.
Oh hey Paul, I didn't see you there. How's it going?
It's going good, not much.
I heard you guys won your game last Friday. What was the score?
Yeah, we won our game 1-0.
Oh, that's really cool. I'm sure a lot of people will like to hear about that. Why don't you submit that to bulletin@infocusnews.tv, and you can hear it on InFocus.
Sure, I'll submit our scores.
Alright, later.
Yeah, see you, man.
Welcome back. Now let's move on to the world of sports. McKenna is in the studio with all the latest.
Thanks, Sarah. There were no games yesterday due to the air quality, but today's air is as fresh as our skills. Girls tennis plays Lynbrook today at 3:30 with varsity playing at Lynbrook and JV playing at home. Girls volleyball is taking on Los Gatos today at home with JV at 5:30 and varsity at 6:45. Boys water polo heads down to Lynbrook with varsity playing at 3:30 and freshmen sophomores playing at 4:45. Girls golf are taking on our rivals Gunn at home at 3:30. Finally, boys and girls varsity cross country have a meet today at 3:15 at the Baylands. Good luck, Bikes. That's all for me. Back to you, Sarah.
McKenna, I think we all know how annoying the reoccurring fire alarms are. Paul Thai dug deep to find the cause of them and interviewed some Pally staff.
The Pally fire alarm has gone off numerous times since the start of the school year. Assistant Principal Mr. Berkson was unable to go on camera but was still able to comment about the situation via email. Mr. Berkson said, "Some students have been caught and dealt with. There is always a chance that there were more students or that alarm goes off due to a faulty system somewhere. I believe the main reason it has stopped is that so many students were upset about it happening so often that the culprits were concerned that even their friends may tell on them." We went around Pally asking students how they felt about the fire alarms going off.
"Fire alarm has impacted my academic results severely, and it's the main cause for most of my grades to be going down.
I think it's like a pretty good thing because then you can get out of class and it's like a break.
It's nice when I'm in a boring class, but it's kind of annoying when I'm taking a test.
It's also annoying when it gets repetitive.
Based on responses from Pally admin and students, the fire alarm going off constantly is impacting many people on campus negatively. From In Focus, I'm Paul Thigh.
Well, that does it for us today. Remember, you can get the latest news from InFocus anytime, anywhere by checking us out at www.infocusnews.tv or find us at InFocus News on Instagram and Facebook and follow us at Pally InFocus on Twitter and Snapchat. Until next time, have a great day, Pally.
Everything is never as it seems. 'Cause I get 1,000 hugs from 10,000 lightning bugs as they tried to teach me how to dance. A foxtrot above my head, a sock hop beneath my bed. A disco ball is just hanging by a thread. Such a